Good evening. Last year's budget and the changes it brought came as a shock to many First Nations peoples. For weeks leading up, the government had signalled things needed to change and too much money was being wasted on red tape in Indigenous Affairs. Still, the scale of the cuts on budget night was massive. $500 million taken out of Indigenous Affairs in what the government called a rationalisation. On the eve of the 2015 budget, our political reporter Myles Morgan takes a look back at last year's budget.
This year's budget papers are hot off the press. But it was last year's effort which revealed the full scale of funding cuts. $534 million axed from the Indigenous Affairs portfolio. The Abbott government said it was a logical cut, with the unveiling of a new funding model for Indigenous organisations, the Indigenous Advancement Strategy. It was spruiked as a way to make things easier for First Nations groups to get government money. Broadly, it didn't.
The Indigenous Advancement Strategy is neither an advancement nor is it strategic. That is the truth of this. It is ridiculous, it is confusing, and it is mean-spirited.
Indigenous health and schooling were the only areas seemingly assured of continuing funding. But for months following the May budget, there was mass confusion amongst many other Indigenous organisations. Community groups were told to aim high in their IAS applications. But many weren't given the money they asked for, or for as long as they needed it.
Woe to go, this has been a debacle of a process. The government has failed and they've caused further chaos for organisations that struggle.
Legal services had nearly all their funding axed just before last year's budget, and there was no new money in 2014. NATSL said it'd be forced to close offices and lay off staff.
The proposed cuts by the federal government mean a number of things. What it'll mean is we will lose our law and justice advocacy role, where we provide community legal education and the basic access to justice rights for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people across Australia. What it also will mean is we'll have a reduced frontline service delivery.
But those cuts were reversed by the government's top lawyer after a huge backlash.
These decisions have been revisited because of the particular need, the particular social need, that the community legal centres address, particularly in relation to domestic violence, and that the Indigenous legal centres address in relation to Indigenous people.
The same for the budget's controversial $7 co-payment, the proposed fee to see a bulk billing doctor. Never adequately explained, always changing and much criticised, it never truly got off the ground and was axed by the Health Minister this year.
The proposal for a co-payment and associated $5 cut to the rebate do not have broad support and will not proceed.
The IAS saw the harshest cuts, but there were others. $15 million was taken away from the National Congress of Australia's First Peoples, our democratically elected voice. Nearly $10 million taken away from the Indigenous Languages Support Program and $2.9 million axed from the National Anti-Tobacco Campaign. But there was investment too. Nearly $30 million towards Indigenous teenage sexual and reproductive health programs, over $10 million for the Clontarf Foundation, $6.8 million for remote schooling, and $3 million for IATSIS, which has just been raised to $5 million for this year's budget.
So what else will we see in this year's budget? Well, we already know the government's priorities when it comes to Indigenous people. Getting the children into school, the adults into work, and making sure they live in safe communities. So it's safe to say that any new money will reflect on those priorities. Myles Morgan, NITV News.